Bella here from Coconut Way. So today I wanted to talk about this very special topic that has been on my heart and I wanted to share because I hope it adds value to your life. This idea of creating your own luck. So I know that a common thing for us to do is to be like, oh, she is so lucky. Some people can look at my life and be like, wow, she is so lucky. She has this business that she started when she's 22. She has this dude. She has this little puppy who's super cute. Like, life is good for her and she's so lucky. And I must say that is so incredibly flattering, and I genuinely just love that encouragement, but at the same time, also take everything with a grain of salt. Like, yes, I can be considered lucky, but it came with plenty of work and lots of behind the scenes stuff that you don't get to see every day. And so I hope that it just reminds you that, you know, like, just remember that it does not come to fruition if you don't put in the work and if you don't give yourself the chance to shine. So what this means is that I believe that luck is when opportunity meets preparation. So before I had Coconut Wise, before I launched it at 22 years old with no business degree, I was a food blogger and had a photography business, people, with my brother. I shot weddings and I was gonna be this brand photographer, and that was really cool. I was in two MLM businesses before then. Like, hello. It really surprises me when people think that what we created was kind of like an overnight success and that somehow I just learned social media and marketing, but it's like, no, it was something that I studied for, you know, quite a bit, to be honest, to get to where I am. It's not like I woke up one day and was like, I'm gonna create this business and I'm gonna know how to manage it. I'm gonna know how to do social media, all these things. No. It was way opposite. It was me pretty much starting at 17, learning about self-development, personal growth, and then getting curious about business and entrepreneurship, and then signing myself up for a few network marketing businesses, which didn't turn out well, but they gave me really great lessons. It opened up my heart to like this world of entrepreneurship and starting my own thing. And so I'm grateful for the experience. And then I had the photography business, and then I launched my blog. And if you didn't know, Miles and I actually launched like an Instagram freshman year of college called We Love Calories. Like, we just love food. We love talking about food. And so we just made a freaking Instagram. Like, it's just about starting and preparing yourself for that big break, for that aha moment that it's like, wow, this seems like something I can do right now and chase and pursue because I'm curious about it and it feels good. And so, like, that's what we did for Coconut Whisk, and to see it at the point that it is today just makes me so incredibly happy, and it makes me realize that anything is literally possible. And I'm not saying that you need to be a business owner. I'm saying that you need to set yourself up for success and you need to create your own luck. And so that's my pep talk of the day. Hopefully that inspires you to start something, start it small, and watch it flourish, because it is going to be so beautiful whatever you do. And remember, everything is progress. Everything. There's no such thing as a failure. It's either I win or I learn. There's nothing else. So with that being said, thank you so much for watching. It's Bella from Coconut Whisk. And of course, if you haven't already, follow us, subscribe to our newsletter, and you can find our stuff at coconutwhisk.com. So talk soon and peace.